L'économie écologique.
Ecological economy is an intellectual international current which dates back to the late 90s. It is both a new scientific discipline and a movement that belongs to civil society, the objective of which, right from the beginning, is to go beyond the divide, the normal divide between disciplines, in order to look at the relationship between economy and environment in the biophysical, ethical, and cultural dimensions, the dimensions that had been disregarded by established disciplines such as ecology and economy in their dominating paradigm. The objective to create an interface between economy and ecology, which is a new interface, is even more attractive because it diffuses at the same time as the new word sustainable development. International Society of Economic Ecology is created at the same time as the Academic Ecological Economy Review in 1989, followed by the creation of 9 regional associations, several more magazines, and conferences are held twice a year with 3,000 members of the current who exchange ideas on the scientific progress and political progress of the project. Attractiveness which also enlarges the scope of disciplines and approaches which are implied in the involved in the current. Now, the idea to work in inter or even transdisciplinarity on how to change the relationship between man and nature impacting decision-making, political decision-making, involves several social sciences and natural sciences. This evolution is obviously not devoid of consequences on the intellectual landscape. Ecological economy must now be considered as the center of gravity where all discussions have to take place regarding sustainable development. And this position is also due to the contradictions going through the current. Just to illustrate this idea, we can take the mapping suggested by Olivier Godard in 2005. Ecological economy is positioned as an approach which aims at studying economies and human societies as it would do for natural systems, which distinguishes it from the standard economic approach, which looks at the environment as if it were a collection of goods, assets, just as anything else, and socioeconomics, which would focus on considering the relationship with natural relation with the natural world in the moral structures. Now, the mapping disregards 2 aspects. The first is that ecological economy partly constitutes the place where we can find pragmatic alliances between economists and biologists in order to enlarge the scope of the standard economic approach to new fields, which itself has built, for instance, for the services rendered by ecosystems, which must be taken into consideration in the decision-making progress so that they can be preserved. The second aspect is that a real ecological socio-economy develops within the current against all pragmatic references to economic categories in order to justify the protection of nature. This may be illustrated with 2 examples. The first example regards relationships between economic growth and sustainable development. There are several contradictory approaches within the same current. The first approach comes from the standard analysis and tries to establish the conditions whereby an economy could grow indefinitely, even taking into consideration the possible degradation of the natural assets. Now, this is one of the components of the total wealth of a country corresponding to its stock of global capital, and from which income or market consumption flows that we try to measure are generated. The conditions for an indefinite growth in this approach would be that the value of this total stock never decreases in time or is maintained on a constant level. But the condition requires that the various components of the total capital can be replaced. Natural capital degradation could be replaced by man-made capital or produced capital. Now, against this idea whereby a stock of capital can be replaced, there is another approach, that of sustainable degrowth, based on thermodynamics and on a vision of a relationship based on metabolism. This approach poses the existence of a fundamental divergence between economic growth and environmental quality or quality of life. The consequence is that this approach tries to find conditions for sustainable degrowth, a degrowth that would allow to take into consideration equality between intra-generational and intergenerational relationships. Now, the third aspect and the major controversy is that regarding divergent conceptions or perspectives of the values we grant to nature and how to use them. Ecological economy is obviously where the standard economic approach can be extended, projecting a marketing framework on environmental aspects. By market framing, we mean that environmental degradations can be explained by the absence of market for said resources. And also real markets or simulated markets are mobilized to make a monetary measurement of the economic value of each individual, what each individual is ready to use to replace natural resources in order to accept that natural resources are degraded. Market instruments or tools are created to manage the resources. And again, there's another approach opposing this approach, a socio-economic ecology, which is opposing framing, market framing, and suggests that we use an ethical kind of framing, saying that environmental degradations are not due to the absence of a market, but to the existence of a market. And also they oppose the incommensurability of the values we attribute to nature, the fact that we can not limit them to common metrics, especially monetary metrics. And finally, it underlies the collective role or the collective dimension of environmental issues, and therefore the role played by political deliberation and the construction of a common vision on goods before decisions are taken, especially public decisions. Through these two examples, we can derive that ecological economy is a political science in sustainable development. And by political, I mean that it approaches large issues in a prescriptive way in order to impact the decision-making process. And political also because when developments are made, it itself is submitted to controversies and disputes within the current, which summarize rather well the way the questions are projected in the citizen debate.